Hello, I'm Brad Wells, and this is my family. It's our privilege and honor to talk to you today about what God has done in Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea is an island located in the South Pacific, just north of Australia.
We have about 5.5 million people divided into three main regions: the islands, the coast, and the highlands. We live in the highlands and enjoy a moderate climate most of the time.
We first arrived in Papua New Guinea in 1998.
I was only 6 months old at the time, so PNG is pretty much all I've ever known. I love the people and the culture of Papua New Guinea. I especially like my hometown, Mount Hagen.
After working with my parents, Dennis and Dee Wells, in the bush for 18 months, God called us to move to a central area where we could plant a church and start the country's first Christian radio station.
We live on about 10 acres, 10 minutes outside of Mount Hagen, so we have lots of room to run and play. I like climbing trees, building forts, and telling people about Jesus.
Our church started in the fall of 1999.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
And Bible FM went on the air in December of 2000.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The radio station has given the children and I a wonderful way of reaching out to thousands of other children throughout Papua New Guinea. We've recorded over 500 daily broadcasts that cover all of the major Bible stories, and some of them several times. And what a wonderful way to not only reach others, but learn ministry together as a family. I can't tell you how many times I've been in the grocery store or at the market, and some mother will come up to me with their child and thank me for teaching their child the Bible. All I can say is, what a privilege.
This past term, we determined to expand our radio station ministry to reach the entire country. I climbed to the top of Mount Wilhelm and placed a tower, a transmitter, a wind generator, 4 solar panels, and a backup battery system. We were able to reach 4 other major cities, broadcasting locally from them, as well as many other parts throughout the country. We used the daisy chain repeater style. It worked beautifully up there on the summit,
until it was sabotaged. I also had the opportunity to climb to the top of the 14,500-foot mountain with my dad. It was no easy task, but my dad climbed it 11 times, just trying to keep the radio station on the air.
In the summer of 2006, I came to the realization that a mountaintop repeater system was just not going to work without the law and order needed to keep it in place. For our last 2 years on the field, we focused most of our attention on discipling our people and maturing the Bible Truth Baptist Church. You see, we wanted our local church to be strong enough to facilitate a nationwide ministry such as radio. Bible FM is still on the air and doing well. We're just not reaching as many people as we would like to be. Meanwhile, though, Bible Truth Baptist Church has begun to take off. We have seen many people saved and baptized and have established the Institute for Bible Truth. Our people are so grateful for what you, the churches of America, have done to establish the ministry, to help them spiritually in the work of the Lord.
Thank you to all churches in America.
And we want to thank you, the people of the United States, for sending missionaries over to Papua New Guinea.
I'd like to say thank you to all the churches in the States for supporting
them. I would like to say thank you for everything.
Thank you for all the missionaries in Papua New Guinea.
I'd like to take this opportunity to
thank you people.
I thank you very much for the support of churches of USA.
Without this being here, to this gathering, I wouldn't have come to know. I accept Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I'm very thankful for
you. I just want to say thank you for sending missionaries. It's such a blessing in our lives.
Thank you, everyone, down at the stage, up at the stage, for sending us your missionary over to us, to PNG.
There is so much work yet to do in Papua New Guinea. We want to see the Bible Truth Baptist Church become a training ground for national young men to take the gospel throughout the entire South Pacific. We would like to aid the churches all over the country in providing discipleship materials at all levels. And our vision for reaching the entire country with Christian radio has never died.
Jesus said, "Lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest." A white harvest. Had he said a golden harvest, well, we might have a week or two to gather. But a white harvest is that final stage. That means any gust of wind or adverse weather means we could lose this harvest forever.
Therefore said he unto them, "The harvest truly is great,
but the laborers are few. Pray therefore the Lord of the harvest
that he would send forth laborers into his harvest."
So what does God want you to do? Does God want you to help us reach the tremendous harvest in New Guinea? You see, there is a harvest, and we're all called to go. It's just a matter of how far and to who. So where's your field?